On this video, I will give you a demo on how to use the Google Mail for G Suite. We will talk about Gmail interface sections, how to compose a message, how to work with labels, how to access the Gmail settings. I have divided the Gmail interface in four sections: Google Bar, Actions, Compose Labels and Chat, Messages. Google or Company Logo. Here is where you will see either the Google logo or your company logo if your administrator has set it up for you. Search box. You can search by specify the sender, specify the recipient, words in the subject line, messages that matches multiple terms, and so much more. You can find all the options to search on the Help Center article in the description. Grid icon. On this button you will find a shortcut of other Google services like Calendar, Drive, and Contacts. Notifications. You can view notifications from a particular Google service like Gmail, Google Plus, or Drive, even when you don't have them open. Account settings. This button will help you sign out of your account, switch accounts, or manage your account settings. For more information about the Google Bar, you can go to the Help Center article listed in the description. I call this section Actions because it allows you to perform different actions with your service. When you click on the mail, you have a drop-down menu where you can go to your contacts or tasks. You can select specific messages like read, unread, and deselect them. You can refresh the page in the case you are expecting a new message. With the More button, without selecting any message, you can mark old unread messages as read. You can move between pages of messages with these buttons. You can access the Gmail settings with the Gear button. When a message is selected, you have more options: archive the message, mark it as spam, delete it, move it to another label, assign a label. The same message can have more than one label assigned to it. With the More button, you can mark as read, mark as important, add to tasks, add a star, filter messages like this, mute. On this section, you can start composing a new message by clicking on the Compose button. I will talk about this later on this video. The labels are a way to organize your messages. You can create a new label, mark a message with it, or move a message to it. I will explain how they work later on this video. The Hangout is your way to communicate with your peers or external people. This will depend if your administrator has granted access to chat externally of your domain. I will create a video where I will talk about Hangouts as there is a lot to cover. On this section, you will find all messages you have received based on the label you have selected. Here you can select a message, star it, and mark it as important. You can see how much of your storage space you are using. Remember that the storage is combined with your Google Drive, Google Photos, and Gmail. Also, you can check your last account activity where you can sign out from any place you have signed in case you don't recognize the location. To compose a new message, you need to click on the Compose button and it will open a new window at the bottom right corner of the screen. Here you can type to who the new message is going to. If you need to add a carbon copy or a blind carbon copy, you can click on the respective button. Enter the subject of the message. And this is where you will type the body of the message. If you want to add format to the body text, you can click on the formatting options and apply any format that you need. You can attach a file by clicking on the clip. You can attach a file from your Google Drive by clicking on the Drive icon. You can attach a photo by clicking on the camera icon. You can add a link by clicking on the chain icon. You can add an emoji by clicking on the happy face. You can discard the message by clicking on the trash can. And you can check spelling and print the message you are composing by clicking on this arrow. Other mail services call them folders, but Google calls them labels, because the way they work gives them more functionality than if they were just folders. You can create a new label by going to the label section, click on more, and then create new label. Enter the name of the label, and if this label will be located under another label, you can use the checkbox next label under and select which label will be the parent label from the drop down menu. When the label is created, it will show up in the list of labels. You can also apply a color for the label so it makes it easy for you to locate. From here, if you want to add the label to a message, you can drag and drop the label to the message. You can add more than one label to the same message if necessary. If you want to move the message to one specific label, you can drag and drop the message into that label. This will not remove other labels assigned to that message. If you need to remove a label from a message, you can select it and click on the labels button. Uncheck the labels you don't want and click on apply. To access the settings of your email account, you can click on the gear button and then on settings. You can manage different settings of your Gmail like language, maximum page size, conversation view, stars, signature, out of the office auto reply. Every time you make changes, you need to save them at the bottom of your page. I hope you like this video. If so, please like it and share it with your friends so more people can watch this channel and learn about its content. And don't forget to subscribe. This is Mac, and see you in my next video.